Welcome to Chapter 3, Levy Jennings Charts and Westgard Rules. Standard deviation is commonly used for preparing Levy Jennings charts. The Levy Jennings chart is used to graph successive, run-to-run, or day-to-day quality control values. A chart is created for each test and level of control. The first step is to calculate decision limits. These limits are positive-negative 1SD, positive-negative 2SD, and positive-negative 3SD from the mean. Let's begin with the data set from the previous module. The mean for the level 1 potassium control is 4.1 millimole per liter, and the standard deviation is 0.1 millimole per liter. This is an illustration of how positive-negative 1SD, positive-negative 2SD, and positive-negative 3SD quality control limits are calculated using that mean and standard deviation. The Levy-Jennings chart we have developed can be overlaid onto a bell-shaped curve to illustrate the overall distribution of quality control values. When an analytical process is within control, approximately 68% of all QC values fall within positive-negative 1 standard deviation. Likewise, 95.5% of all QC values fall within positive-negative 2 standard deviations of the mean. About 4.5% of all data will be outside the positive-negative 2S limits when the analytical process is in control. Approximately 99.7% of all QC values are found to be within positive-negative 3 standard deviations of the mean. As only 0.3%, or 3 out of 1,000 points, will fall outside the positive-negative 3S limits, any value outside the positive-negative 3S is considered to be associated with a significant error condition, and patient results should not be reported. Some laboratories consider any quality control value outside its positive-negative 2S limits to be out of control. They incorrectly decide that the patient's specimens and QC values are invalid. An analytical run should not be rejected if a single quality control value is outside the positive-negative 2S QC limits, but within the positive-negative 3S QC limits. Approximately 4.5% of all valid QC values will fall somewhere between positive-negative 2 and positive-negative 3 standard deviation limits. Laboratories that use a positive-negative 2S limit frequently reject good runs. That means patient samples are repeated unnecessarily, labor and materials are wasted, and patient results are unnecessarily delayed. The laboratory needs to document that quality control materials are assayed and that the quality control results have been inspected to assure the quality of the analytical run. This documentation is accomplished by maintaining a QC log and using the Levy-Jennings chart on a regular basis. The QC log can be maintained on a computer or on paper. The log should identify the name of the test, the instruments, units, the date the test is performed, the initials of the person performing the test, and the results for each level of control assayed. Optional items for the log include method and the assay temperature, usually included for enzymes. There should be room to write in actions taken to resolve any situation which is identified as out of control or unacceptable and a place for documentation of supervisory review. Once the QC results are entered into the QC log, they should be plotted on the Levy-Jennings chart. When the results are plotted, an assessment can be made about the quality of the run. The technologist/technician performing the test should look for systematic error and random error. Systematic error is evidenced by a change in the mean of the control values. The change in the mean may be gradual and demonstrated as a trend in control values, or it may be abrupt and demonstrated as a shift in control values. A trend indicates a gradual loss of reliability in the test system. The trends are usually subtle. Causes of trends may include deterioration of the instrument light source, gradual accumulation of debris in sample reagent tubing, gradual accumulation of debris on electrode surfaces, aging of reagents, gradual deterioration of control materials, gradual deterioration of incubation chamber temperature enzymes only, gradual deterioration of light filter integrity, gradual deterioration of calibration. Abrupt changes in the control mean are defined as shifts. Shifts in QC data represent a sudden and dramatic positive or negative change in test system performance. Shifts may be caused by sudden failure or change in the light source, change in reagent formulation, change of reagent lot, major instrument maintenance, sudden change in incubation temperature enzymes only, change in room temperature or humidity, failure in the sampling system, failure in reagent dispense system, inaccurate calibration recalibration. Technically, random error is any deviation away from an expected result. For QC results, any positive or negative deviation away from the calculated mean is defined as random error. There is acceptable or expected random error as defined and quantified by standard deviation. There is unacceptable, unexpected random error that's any data point outside the expected population of data, e.g. a data point outside the positive-negative 3S limits. In 1981, Dr. James Westgaard of the University of Wisconsin published an article on laboratory quality control that set the basis for evaluating analytical run quality for medical laboratories. The elements of the Westgaard system are based on principles of statistical process control used in industry nationwide since the 1950s. There are 6 basic rules in the Westgaard scheme. These rules are used individually or in combination to evaluate the quality of analytical runs. Westgaard devised a shorthand notation for expressing quality control rules. Most of the quality control rules can be expressed as NL, where N represents the number of control observations to be evaluated, and L represents the statistical limit for evaluating the control observations. Thus, 1-3-S represents a control rule that's violated when one control observation exceeds the positive-negative 3-S control limits. The 1-2-S rule is a warning rule that's violated when a single control observation is outside the positive-negative 2-S limits. Remember that in the absence of added analytical error, about 4.5% of all quality control results will fall between the 2S and 3S limits. This rule merely warns that random error or systematic error may be present in the test system. The relationship between this value and other control results within the current and previous analytical runs must be examined. If no relationship can be found and no source of error can be identified, it must be assumed that a single control value outside the positive-negative 2S limits is an acceptable random error. Patient results can be reported. The 1-3-S rule identifies unacceptable random error, or possibly the beginning of a large systematic error. Any QC result outside positive-negative 3S violates this rule. The 2-2-S rule identifies systematic error only. The criteria for violation of this rule are 2 consecutive QC results, greater than 2S, on the same side of the mean. There are 2 applications to this rule, within run and across runs. The within run application affects all control results obtained for the current analytical run. For example, if a normal level 1 and abnormal level 2 control are assayed in this run, and both levels of control are greater than 2S on the same side of the mean, this run violates the within-run application for systematic error. If, however, level 1 is negative 1S and level 2 is positive 2.5S, a violation of the 1-2S rule, the level 2 result from the previous run must be examined. If level 2 in the previous run was at plus 2S or greater, then the across-run application for systematic error is violated. Violation of the within-run application indicates that systematic error is present and that it affects potentially the entire actual curve. Violation of the across-run application indicates that only a single portion of the analytical curve is affected by the error. The R4S rule identifies random error only and is applied only within the current run. If there is at least a 4S difference between control values within a single run, the rule is violated for random error. For example, assume both level 1 and level 2 have been assayed within the current run. Level 1 is positive 2.8S above the mean, and level 2 is negative 1.3S below the mean. The total difference between the two control levels is greater than 4S. E.g., plus 2.8S minus negative 1.3S equals 4.1S. Violation of any of the following rules does not necessarily require rejection of the analytical run. These violations typically identify smaller systematic error or analytical bias that's not often clinically significant or relevant. Analytical bias may be eliminated by performing calibration or instrument maintenance. The following criteria must be met for a 3-1S rule violation: 3 consecutive results, greater than 1S, on the same side of the mean. The following criteria must be met for a 4-1S rule violation: 4 consecutive results, greater than 1S, on the same side of the mean. There are two applications to the 3-1S and 4-1S rule. These are within control material, e.g. all level 1 control results, or across control materials, e.g. level 1, 2, and 3 control results in combination. Within control material violations indicate systematic bias in a single area of the method curve, while violation of the across control materials application indicates systematic error over a broader concentration. These rules are violated when there are 7 or 8, or 9 or 10 or 12 control results on the same side of the mean, regardless of the specific standard deviation in which they're located. Each of these rules also has two applications. Within control material, e.g. all level 1 control results, or across control materials, e.g. level 1, 2, and 3 control results in combination. Within control material violations indicates systematic bias in a single area of the method curve, while violation of the across control materials application indicates systematic bias over a broader concentration. We've reached the end of this module. Let's review some basic points. The Levy-Jennings chart is used to graph successive, run-to-run, or day-to-day quality control values. The first step in creating a Levy-Jennings chart is to calculate decision limits. These limits are positive negative 1S, positive negative 2S, and positive negative 3S from the mean. Some laboratories consider any quality control value outside its positive negative 2S limits to be out of control. They incorrectly decide that the patient's specimens and QC values are invalid. Approximately 4.5% of all valid QC values will fall somewhere between positive negative 2 and positive negative 3 standard deviation limits. The laboratory needs to document that quality control materials are assayed and that the quality control results have been inspected to assure the quality of the analytical run. Systematic error is evidenced by a change in the mean of the control values. The change in the mean may be gradual and demonstrated as a trend in the control values, or it may be abrupt and demonstrated as a shift in control values. A trend indicates a gradual loss of reliability in the test system. Trends are usually subtle. Abrupt changes in the control mean are defined as shifts. Shifts in QC data represent a sudden and dramatic positive or negative change in test system performance. Technically, random error is any deviation away from an expected result. In 1981, Dr. James Westgaard of the University of Wisconsin published an article on laboratory quality control that set the basis for evaluating analytical run quality for medical laboratories. There are 6 basic rules in the Westgaard scheme. These rules are used individually or in combination to evaluate the quality of analytical runs. The 1-2-S rule is a warning rule that's violated when a single control observation is outside the positive-negative 2S limits. The 1-3-S rule identifies unacceptable random error, or possibly the beginning of a large systematic error. The 2-2-S rule identifies systematic error only. The R-4-S rule identifies random error only, and is applied only within the current run. The 7x or 8x, or 9x or 10x or 12x rules identify consecutive points on the same side of the mean, regardless of the specific standard deviation in which they're located. For all of your laboratory QC needs, go to www.qcnet.com.